Hello friends, in continuation to our yesterday's class, today we shall discuss about T cell immunity mechanism. T cell immunity mechanism. What is T in T cell? T stands for thymus. These are the important lymphocytes and our immune cells, which are essential point or crux points in third line of defense. As I told you in yesterday's class, B cells and T cells are the essential cells in third line of defense. And T cells is one among them. Okay? And these T cells give their birth in bone marrow. Then they go to thymus. Why they are considered as thymus T cells? Why they are named after thymus? Because after they give their birth, they go to thymus for differentiation into mature T cells, otherwise called immunocompetent T cells. Then they go to secondary lymphoid organs to become functional immune cells. That means they go to thymus to become immunocompetent T cells. Later they go to secondary lymphoid organs to become functional cells. T cells are of two types, TH or CD4, TC or CD8 cells. What is the differentiation? That means the distinction between TC and TH is the cluster of differentiation. Cluster of differentiation is nothing but certain glycoprotein molecules present on the T cell membrane or differentiates T cells into two types. Say for example, in one T cell there is cluster of differentiation 4, CD4. In another type there is cluster of differentiation 8, CD8. For example, it is CD4. This is T cell receptor. It is CD4. Whereas it is TC, it contains CD8. This CD4 and CD8 are the main distinction between the two. And based on the function, they also can consider as TH. H stands for helper cells. And TC, C stands for cytotoxic, otherwise called killer cells. Help, the name it implied, it helps. Cytotoxic, the name it implied, killer cells. First of all, we look at TH cells, how it helps and to which cells it will help. TH cells, otherwise called T helper cells, the most important cells, because they act as bridge between humoral immunity and the cell mediated immunity. The B cell mediated immunity, that means mediated by antibodies, is called humoral immunity. We have discussed in the last class, and in the present class we are going to discuss about cell mediated immunity. The bridge between these two is by TH cells. They connect both humoral and cell mediated. Help, as I told you, why it is considered as a helper cells? They help B cells to produce antibodies. They help TC cells, its counterpart, to become active into cytotoxic T lymphocytes that leads to apoptosis. Apoptosis of the target cell. That means it is the effector cell. And they help mononuclear phagocytes, MNPs, to cause phagocytosis. That means major types of immune responses, say phagocytosis, apoptosis and antibodies. This is 1, 2, 3. All done by TH cells. They help. That is why they are known as T helper cells. And which kind of cells help these TH cells? The macrophages. The macrophages, they produce cytokines to help T cells to become activated. Okay, Then next is TC cells. TC cells. There is one direct point. When the TH cells activate TC cells, they become CTLs. And when the CTLs form, they kill the target cell by apoptosis. We should discuss later in the cell mediated immunity how the CTLs kill the target cells. Simple. They shall get activated by TH cells, they become CTLs, that means effector cells, cytotoxic T lymphocytes. That means TCLs become CTLs, then apoptosis. Simply they kill the target cell like tumor cells or the virus infected cells. And most important point of T cells that we have to remember is, unlike B cells, T cells won't produce antibodies. Unlike B cells, they won't directly react with antigens. Say for example, B cells through its antibodies at the membrane react with circulating antigens, but T cells won't. They have to be presented, that means the antigens should present to the TC cells by APCs and ASCs. This is very important. APCs, antigen presenting cells, and ACS, altered cell cells. Altered cell cells, okay. Antigen presenting cells means, for example, the B cells, the dendritic cells, the macrophages. This altered cell cell means tumor cells or the virus infected cells. After we discuss about cell mediated immunity, I will tell you what is APCs and ASCs, okay. Now we'll discuss about how the T cell defend our body against the pathogens. Okay. What we call cell mediated immunity. The kind of T cell immunity mechanism is cell mediated immunity. It is brought about by activated T cells, NK cells. Predominantly these two cells are involved in cell mediated immunity. Before we go into the exact mechanism, we have to discuss about some basics. I told you what are APCs, antigen presenting cells, and ASCs, altered cell cells. APCs, they process the exogenous antigens, whereas ASCs, they process the endogenous antigens. And APCs, I told you, T cells won't react directly to antigens. They have to be get presented by antigen presenting cells and the altered cell cells. And these APCs, they present antigen, that means exogenous antigens, to TH cells by MHC class 2. Whereas altered cell cells, they present endogenous antigens to TC cells by MHC class 1. This is very important point. They have to get presented by the processed antigens by APCs and ASCs through respect to a major histocompatibility complex, MHC means. Okay? Then only they get react. Okay? Imagine T cells got react and how they defend. This is very important. What is the exact mechanism? You know, first of all, I told you already, say it's an exogenous antigen, it's a phagocyte, say macrophages, okay, they will engulf and break down to smaller bits and they present by means of MHC class 2, this antigenic fragment, to TH cell, this is CD4, okay, and these activated TH cell release interleukins. Interleukins are one of the potential soluble mediators. They activate different immune cells, leading to proliferation and differentiation. Proliferation into effector cells. I will tell you how it works. Interleukins. Okay, this is exogenous. Then, and this is endogenous. Endogenous antigens. They are presented by MHC class 1 to TC cell. MHC class 1, this is very important. This is TC cell. Okay. They get activated. These activated TC cells get stimulated by the interleukins released by the activated TH cell. This leads to the differentiation of effector cell. That means TC cell turn up into an effector cell, what we call cytotoxic T lymphocytes. And memory T cells. TC memory and the CTLs. And this CTL, this is very important. They release perforins. Perforins. Say this is the target cell. Let me say this is the infected cell, okay? They react with the infected cell and they release perforins, and these perforins causes holes. Perforin, the name it implies, causes perforations, holes in the infected cell. Okay? And through these holes, these CTLs release another transgene called granzymes. Granzymes. This is very important. They enter inside the infected cell. And these granzymes activate caspases inside the target cell, inside the infected cell, and these caspases ultimately leads to apoptosis. The programmed cell death is called apoptosis. Mitochondria controls it, okay? Leads to apoptosis. So simple, this is the core theme, the central dogma of cell mediated immunity. The exogenous, the TH cells, they are activated by the MHC2, then they release interleukins, and the activated TC cells become CTLs. They release perforins. Perforins form holes in the infected cell, and these perforins, through which the granzymes releases inside, and these granzymes activates the caspases, and these caspases leads to apoptosis, what we call programmed cell death. Okay, this is the cell mediated immunity. And as I told you, we have to discuss about certain important cells: antigen presenting cells, altered cell cells, and auxiliary cells. Then only we can discuss what the conditions, okay? Only I can understand for better conditions. Antigen presenting cells. The antigen presenting cells, I told you, they are dendritic cells, for example, B cells and macrophages. They release, they process the antigen polypeptides and present to TH cells through MHC2. Whereas altered cell cells, the name, it is our own host cells, our own cells, say for instance viral infected cells or the tumor cells, virus infected cells or tumor cells. They process endogenous antigens, and through MHC1 they present it to TC cells. So for activation of TH cells and TC cells, these APCs and altered cell cells are very, very, very important. Apart from these two, that means antigen presenting cells and the altered cells, so there are auxiliary cells. There are one more, third category of cells, auxiliary cells. The name it implied, it helps. APCs are one kind of auxiliary cells. Apart from antigen presenting cells, auxiliary cells are also like, say, mast cells, say basophils, say platelets. They release inflammatory mediators. Inflammatory mediators that causes inflammation. I told you in the last class, immune system, that means, is nothing but an organized network of organs, cells, proteins, and these are all different proteins and cells. These are dendritic cells, mast cells, you know, cytokines, interleukins, interferons, all these are proteins. They, in an integrated manner, they defend our body. That means to defend against the incoming pathogens. And at the same time, the inward pathogen, what we call endogenous antigen. This is the overall flux point, the overall inference for immunity, okay? At the same time, the one more important cell, that is natural killer cells. They're also important. Why they are considered as natural killer cells? NK cells. They're called large granular lymphocytes. NK cells because they are in active state. Unlike TC cells, they are not in inactive form. Say TC cell, they require some activation by TH cells, by interleukins, and they have to convert into CT cells, CTLs. But here, in case cells, there is no need. They are in readily active form. They are most important innate immune cell. And their mode of defense mechanism is, they release perforins. Granzymes, similar to the CTLs. These two perforins and granzymes, they kill the target cell. Say cell lysis. Apart from these natural killer cells, there are also macrophages. There are two types. Then one is mononuclear phagocytes. Another one is polymorphonucleus, nuclear cells. PMNs, they are like granulocytes. Here example, Kupffer cells. These macrophages, as I told you now, they are very much important cells in second line of defense. So all these cells, in macrophages, NK cells, auxiliary cells, APCs, ASCs, help and aids involve the main cells, that means T cells and B cells, to defend our system, that means the immune system. When these all together fail, that means the first round of defense fails, the second round of defense fails, the third round of defense fails, then the disease occurs. Okay? We should discuss other issues in the next class, okay? You can subscribe. Thank you.